Some of you may become somewhat uncomfortable as parts of this film unfold.
If you listen carefully, you will agree that the concepts will contribute to the rearing of a mature person who has a healthy, responsible attitude toward the sexual side of his life.
Hi, my dear girls, non-binary people, and boys. I'm Nadya, I'm a co-founder of Pussy Riot on quarantine, as the whole world. I learned how to record my own voice, because before I was working with producers in their studios, and I was super insecure about myself and my technical abilities. So quarantine actually helped me to believe in myself. I'm keep creating music, and I'm lucky enough to be on the lockdown with my partner who makes music, graphic design, art. His name is Santi, I'm Imkorpo. And so together we're filming music videos, making photo sessions, and writing music. So actually this time was quite productive for us, and hope for you too. Today, I'm in Los Angeles. The United States are in a very interesting position now. A few days ago, I went to protests regarding the murder of George Floyd. It's really heartbreaking what's happening in this country currently, because I've been seeing it happening for years and years, and nothing seems to change that much. In 2014, an Afro-American United States citizen, Eric Garner, was killed by police because he was selling cigarettes on the streets of New York. And we were so devastated by this death. We felt it was really like a part of our own agenda. Though we are Russians, and many would say that we should not worry about it. I'm an anarchist, I'm an activist, and I believe in global solidarity. I believe that only if we unite to protect our interests, then we have a chance to win. Because people who we're fighting with, people who are expressing racism, violence, who are promoting global inequality, those systems are building global alliances all the time. Like transnational corporations and transnational alliances between governments, and we should do the same.
Ah, 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 ah. paradise. We'll lock them up. We all gotta sacrifice. It won't be long. Shut the borders, perfect orders. Sons and daughters, hang the martyrs. Drink the Kool-Aid, it's the new way. Do what I say. Oh my God, I'm so happy I could die. Oh my God, I'm so happy I could cry. Everyone is doing the same thing. It makes me happier, makes me happier. Everyone is doing the same thing. It makes me happier, makes me happier. Golden idol, golden rifles. Take my money, anybody. I'm your trophy, make my nose bleed. Now you owe me.
Racism comes from inequality, not only from obviously, but racism is based in a lot of ways on financial inequality, because people don't have equal opportunities. And if you're born in a family that don't have money to provide you great education, it means that you're stuck in being poor. So I hope that pandemic will make people think about these issues more and really makes them organize and protect their interests. I feel like we have to make some steps to overcome the despair that we feel in the face of the oppressive system. And I came up with some sort of solutions for myself, because I live in under repressive regime since 2000, and most of my life I spent with Vladimir Putin in my bed. So I feel like there are some rules that you can apply to any oppressive system. I feel like the most important thing is to tell yourself that it's okay to feel depressed, it's okay to feel shitty, because what capitalist system teaches us to do, to think that everything that's wrong with us is our personal problem. And if I feel sad, if I feel depressed, it must be something wrong with me. Not necessarily. You don't necessarily have to take a pill or go to a doctor and pay $200 for a visit. No. Look around you, maybe there are some issues that are causing this inner conflict that manifests as depression. And lacking of communication, of organization, of that simple, such a simple thing as community, which is so natural for humans. Lacking these simple things makes us depressed. Plan, organize, find a way how to express your anger in a sustainable way, in a lasting way, so it gives all of us long-term results. That's been my recipe for years, and maybe it will help you too.
I'm Korpo, and I'm going to show you what are the things I'm using for music. The first is Volga beats to make the drums. I have My Roland 303. This is from Behringer, but it's the same. It's a classic machine, and I always use it to make the acid line. And after, I have Bridger Crave, and it's amazing. It's like a semi-modular synth. I use it for bass mostly.
Deadline. That's a big and important issue for me. I feel like everyone wants to get the production value these days, and that's kind of tiring. And like, look at 100 Jacks. I mean, their music videos are fucking amazing, but they're the easiest and the simplest videos you've seen in the last decade, probably. But they're viral, they're really appealing to people. I don't have to have like incredible amount of money that you spend on equipment and the team. You can just, you know, you can just express yourself within, like, with things that you have, like with things that I have right now. I have my phone, and I have my voice, and I have my brain. I can deliver my thoughts to you. That's that simple. You don't have to have a crew of professionals who are surrounding me all the time, because they, in a lot of situations, they just make things fucking harder, and they stress you, and they make you feel like you're working. We will definitely see economic crisis, and I would love to see more redistribution happening as a result of this pandemic. I would love to see less financial inequality, because that's been like one of the biggest issues I've been thinking in the last years. Because all the problems that we are tackling as activists, they have an underlying root, and that's global inequality that's skyrocketing right now. I feel like current political system doesn't know how to address these issues yet. People like Bernie Sanders, they give me hope, but unfortunately he's not the candidate. And I feel like it requires a mass people movement to really change this situation and to show them that we're the many and you're the few guys, and you have to share. It's been like really fun to record this set, because I miss live performances. This is a really important part of my life. I really hope it will come back rather sooner than later, when it's all fine and healthy for all of us to gather again and mosh and go crazy. I had a little glimpse of what I lost, so thank you for that. The song I performed is Straight Out of Vagina. I want to say that you don't have to have vagina in order to be a woman, and having vagina doesn't necessarily make you a woman. So don't take the song literally. Well, it's just a fun song about my frustration with people not saying word vagina, because it's like everyone says dick, 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 as like I have heard everywhere. But when it comes to female reproductive system, people are afraid of these words, like they're dirty or something. So yeah, we made a song because of that. Does your vagina have a friend? Let your vagina start the band.
got a lot to say.
Dumb place to be, dumb place, dumb vaginas. Where are you really from? CM, put your pussy on a diet. Then pop my breath, you're gonna start a riot. Don't play stupid, don't play dumb vaginas. Where are you really from? Don't play stupid, don't play dumb vaginas. Where are you really from?
Thank you for being with us and come to see us live when we all have chance to have it again. Love, solidarity, peace. Peace, right?
Органы, 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 органы. Органы в рясах и органы в погонах.